didn't even have to happen. But these guys won it, so I think it's a great fight. Whoever made this fight, you know, deserve kudos, because this is going to be a fight.
Yeah, it'll be a barn burner. They it's both come a, forward, they both let their hands go. Someone's going to knock it. No need for judges or a referee.
You don't need either one.
And I like it that way. No controversy. It's not going to be one of those scorecards. Someone's going to sleep.
It's
going to
be a fight. And you know what? People should be killing themselves to try to get a ticket.
I told them that. But the media likes to destroy everything. It's a fun fight.
I'm telling you,
you'll enjoy it.
This is one of the best fights in the sport of boxing that could be made. Especially at heavyweight. You don't get heavyweight fights like this. You really don't. And this is one of the best fights that could ever be made. So whoever the matchmaker was for this, kudos. Because you deserve it. And these two guys deserve it. You know, because look, this is going to be a fun fight. And, you know, I think Ruiz, because, I don't know. I just don't know how he's going to react to the weight loss. You know, I don't know, like 20 pounds or something like that.
Yep.
You know, 20 pounds, it could be a lot for a fighter like him, because he was able to solve so much punches, you know, with being a bigger guy. But now, a little bit smaller, 20 pounds is no joke. You know, can he handle the punches? Let me tell you something. Areola, you know, I think Joe Gustafson has done a great job with Chris. You know, Chris is really looking good. And, you know, and I think, you know, Chris is a fighter, man. You know, I worked with Chris before myself, so I know what kind of guy he is, you know, and he's not going to back down. It's going to be a tough fight, and it's going to be a great fan-friendly fight.
Now, this week, a legend passed away, Marvin Hagler. Ronnie, you fought in his era.
Yes.
Do you ever meet him?
I met him one time.
What was that like? I mean, who was he? I mean, I've met him in his older age. I didn't meet him in his heyday when he was larger than life. What do you remember from him?
I just remember, you know, he was a nice, quiet guy. You know, he wasn't a braggadocious kind of guy. You know, he was a real quiet guy. You know, but you know, I only really got to meet him one time. I've seen him a few other times, but never really talked to him. But, you know, look, man, we lost a legend in the sport.
He was very young.
Absolutely, what, 66, you know? And, you know, I want to say my good condolences to his family. And, you know, but he was a legend in the sport. No ifs, ands, or buts about it. But, you know, he was somebody that, if you know, you see that when he fought Sugar Ray Leonard, you know, he actually thought he won the fight.
He did.
I actually thought he won the fight also. And that really ticked them off, that they took the fight from him. And this is the reason he quit the sport, you know?
To this day, well, now he passed away, but a couple years ago, I interviewed him, and he was like, I won the fight. Then I interviewed Sugar Ray Leonard, I won the fight. Like, they, even though it's been all, and their kids get along. Their kids are best friends.
Yes, I know they are.
Which is, like, the dads may have a little disagreement, but the Marvin Hagler Jr. with Leonard Jr., Sugar Ray Leonard Jr. with Tommy Hearns Jr. and Roberto Duran's daughter, they're all friends, which is amazing.
That's a good thing, though. That's good, because it just lets you know, man, life is short, you know, and, you know, friends come from all over. You know, you don't have to be a certain color, creed, whatever. You know, you can
just
be friends.
Just be a good person.
That's it. You just be a good person, and, you know, that's a good thing. You know, I mean, look, all of those guys made history with each other. You know, so why not the kids come together and they just enjoy that, you know, that these guys did something for us, for the whole world that everybody saw. Yeah.
And two of their kids were in a Pepsi commercial, but I forgot which two. But there you have it. Ronnie, are you on social media if everybody wants to follow you?
Yes, at Official Ronnie Shields.
Make sure to follow him, Official Ronnie. Is that new? Sort of?
It's been about a few months now.
Okay, well, now we'll let people know. Official Ronnie Shields. Stay tuned. EsNewsReporting.com. I'll be back reporting.